Hello everyone. So today we are continuing our first lesson, integers from the 7th standard maths with the point properties of integer. In our last lecture, we have the properties of integers for addition, and today we are going to have the properties of integers for subtraction. Means subtraction properties of integers. So the same properties, closure property. So what is the closure property of an integer for subtraction? If we subtract, suppose a and b are the two integers, then we can say the subtraction of any two integers is always an integer. So this is the closure property, whereas your second property is commutative property. Commutative. Commutative property. It is about the, suppose three numbers a, b and c, these three are the integers, then if you subtract any three numbers in any order, that means a minus b minus c is not equal to a minus b minus c. With an example we can prove or verify that by as, suppose a is equal to 5, b is equal to 3 and c is equal to 1, that property you can write a minus b minus c, the left hand side of a property, and you can solve 5 minus 2 and your answer is 3. Whereas the right hand side a minus b minus c. 5 minus 3 is 2 minus 1, the answer is 2. You can check your left hand side and right hand side of the property which is not equal, the answer is different. So the commutative property for subtraction of integer is not 2. Next property is an associative property. There are the three integers, then your associative property we can mention as, okay, a minus b is not equal to b minus a. With an example, suppose your a is 5 and b is, the value is 3, then 5 minus 3 is 2, whereas b minus a is at minus 2. So again you can say closure property is under the subtraction in case of the integer, whereas the associative and commutative properties are not true for the subtraction of integers. Now before starting that addition and subtraction of an integers, there is one question in your exercise. It is about the arranging the given numbers according to the least to the greatest number. So your example is 8, 12, 3, minus 10, minus 14, 4. So the question is, arrange that given integers according to ascending order. Then question is, arrange that integers from least to greatest number. That means you have to arrange ascending order. So for that we should have to know which is the least number. 8, 12, 3, 4. These are the positive integers. So minus 10 and minus 14, out of these two, one should be the least. Because for the integers we have some properties. First thing, all the positive integers are always greater than the negative integers. Also, 0 is also always greater than any negative integer, and the right side number on the number line is always greater than the left hand side number. So I'll draw a number line to better understanding, because minus 10 and minus 14, out of these two, one is the least. So if the 0 is here, we can write the negative numbers like minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 10, minus 11, minus 12, That means your least integer is minus 14. So that number you have to write first. Before that, mention ascending order. Minus 14, then minus 10. Left over integers are positive, so you can easily arrange them. 3, 4, 8 and 12. So this way you have to arrange their ascending order. Now after that order, there is one more question. Compare the given integers. The first example is 113. That number you have to compare with minus 113. Second example, 923. You have to compare with the 231. Okay? Your third example is